Dennis wrote a script in 1978 that was the outline of this story the way I adapted. I took it in a different direction. But I have been, one way or another, been conducting a dialogue on this story since about 1978. I optioned it twice, wrote two different drafts, abandoned them, and then went to the one that became the graphic novel and has now become the film. So it's been a long haul on this one, but I'm very pleased with the cast and their performance, and I think the movie's got a wicked sense of fun, and what can I tell you? I'm happy with it. One, I'm very pleased and honored that they asked us to come here. They've treated us sensationally. It's a beautiful city, and so I'm very pleased, yeah.
I mean, Walter, you've been fighting for this project for a very long time. Can you talk a little bit about the qualities, what made Michelle and people like Sigourney the right fit for these roles?
Well, have you seen the film? Yeah. There's a very big dynamic, a very large dynamic of high and low. You have somebody that's made, scratched out a living as a professional criminal from the lowest ebb of society. You've got somebody who is very well educated and very articulate, who is now in an insane asylum. So it's a story between these two very disparate types.
This is a film that deals with a subject matter that has proved controversial and at least provoked discussion before people have even seen the film. How do you feel about that aspect of the reaction?
I mean, I think, look, the logic of condemning something before it's even not only not seen, not even made, seems to me to be utterly ridiculous. But I certainly was aware that after that it was going to be a volatile. I was asked many times to make comments about all that. I said the movie will be my response, and the movie is my response. It's not a comment about the transgender movement or something like that. The character is not transgender. The character is somebody that goes through a genital alteration and feminization, but inside his head he never changes.
Sebastian is somebody who's gotten into a lot of trouble with all kinds of people, and he's sort of the reason, what happens to him is the reason that the movie moves forward. And so you see he's a little boy who hasn't grown up, but he has a lot of toys and gets into a lot of trouble doing it. Well, Walter is an old-time Hollywood, he's a legendary director, and he's done some of the most amazing movies, like Long Riders, 48 Hours, and across genres, westerns, and he really brings a kind of a dark vision to this. It's almost film noir, what he's done. It's basically film noir, what he's done. So Walter brings all of those years of experience and talent and, you know, his gift for working with other people and actors to the movie, so it's going to be extraordinary. Well, Michelle is one of those performers who doesn't show you that she's working. She just comes and she's very laid back and she's very easy. And then you see the result and you go, oh, you were doing all that. She's very clever at concealing the work that she does, but she's very, very, very talented, extraordinary to work with. Well, I think that people should see the film before they make judgments based on those ideas. I think you're referring to the LGBTQ issue. But
I guess, obviously, you know, it's a film that is of relevance to the trans community, and they've certainly had a reaction, and like you say, before they've seen it in many cases.
It is. Well, I mean, it's a film noir thriller, and couched in it is a theme about who we are inside versus who we are on the outside. So I think it's worth seeing for everybody.
What does it mean for you to be a part of this year's TIFF lineup?
Well, it's a big thrill for me. Just because I'm part of a big film, and I'm, you know, have a really lovely part in it, and I get to work with lovely people, so it's fabulous.
And it was a great experience. I mean, how often do you get to play a guy who gets an unwanted sex change? It's not often.
Right. What was the preparation that went into that then for you?
I only had 3 weeks to prepare, so we're talking, you know, voice and working out as much, drinking protein, see if I could gain any weight in the 3 weeks that I had.
What was the most challenging? a new part.
It was tough. That's what I'm saying. You know, it was the voice and trying to get that down as possible and trying to get his character down in 3 weeks. That's
the
tough.
The storyline sounds a little bit like an Almodovarian film, but it's not at all.
It's so, not that deep. Yeah. No. It's like if Almodovar met a propaganda artist who was into pulp.
Audiences take away from this film then?
You know what? The shock and awe of an alternative world somewhere in the graphic novel realm of things. It's just a weird dream that you walked in on and you're wondering how you feel about it after. You don't know whether to be shocked or surprised or like what to feel.